right, guys, so I can't believe we're doing this. So I'm gonna be watching a clip of me. I'm gonna be watching my audition tape.
I can go clean up the rest of the house before I go to sleep.
We have a house full of guests. I expect you to help, not sit in your room.
I wasn't feeling well.
You never feel well.
My lips are so dry, guys. It's really, that's the only thing I can see.
You play along just to keep you happy. God bless the mass you open me. You know, sometimes it feels like
what?
Like she means more to you than I'm Lucia.
Like this is bullying, for sure, bullying.
I just want our family to be like everyone else's, man. Why can't we be normal?
I get it, bullying, I do.
Why can't we be
normal? I know, it's hard.
Am I doing the thing?
Who wants me?
Hi.
My lips are so dry. I don't know why they didn't like tell me, girl, go put on some Vaseline or something. Like my lips are so dry.
Okay then, girl. Okay.
God, she's so cute.
Yeah, no, Alma's killing it. She's killing
it. If I was a director or casting director, I'd be like, bro, this girl's lips are dry. Like, no. Next.
This is very awkward. Okay, watching my own audition.
We have a house full of guests. I expect you to help. Not sit around in your room.
I wasn't feeling well.
You never feel well, Blake.
Why, guys? Why are we doing this?
I try to make this day special for you, Asia. The least you can do is show some appreciation.
I'm sorry, Mom, but I...
This woman just has a certain presence about her, and like, I don't know how to describe it, but Gail is literally such a beautiful actress, like watching her.
I just want our family to be like everyone else's, Mom. Why can't you be normal?
She took a moment, she sat there. And she looked at her.
I get it. And with the divorce, I want you to know that your dad and I love you. That is never going to change.
She's killing it. I'm going to cry.
Where is her Oscar nomination? Where is her Oscar nomination, guys?
Gail is. I mean.
Everything, the hair, Look, thank you. Can we move on to the other guys now? Because this is really awkward.
I've probably just been looking at the choices I made, how nervous I was, and the nonsense that I did, because I now have the tendency of doing quite a bit of nonsense.
Oh, sorry, I'm so sorry. I wasn't watching you sleep or anything creepy like that. I just got you. Promise. Wait, Daniel.
Oh, this is a completely different scene.
Hey.
I'm smiling wild.
Look at her.
Hey. I went, hey.
I just gotta put it.
Hey.
Look at her.
Amy? Who's Amy? There's no Amy on the show. We need to start a campaign. Who is Amy?
No. You hungry? You play PlayStation? I got mad skills, yo.
I paused there. And I don't know why I paused. I went, you hungry? You play PlayStation? And I looked to the side and I pouted. Dylan?
Exactly like Wayne. Exactly like Wayne.
You talk a lot.
I know, I do. And I gotta work on it. It's just. Whenever I get nervous, I talk a lot. And the more I talk, the more nervous I get.
Yeah, I feel like Dylan from the get go just was so perfect for Wayne.
Everything he's saying right now is not on the show, it wasn't on the script. Like, who's Amy?
He nailed the Wade character, and yeah, Dylan, your audition is hella funny. I don't remember the scene from the show.
I think I'm still gonna believe I pouted, but I wait. Okay, that was a start to Wade. So I'm just gonna.
I just know I'm gonna cringe. I just know what this is gonna be so cringe for me, watching mine.
So, what's your poison? You want a bit of herb or will ethanol do just fine?
KB lives here with his parents and they know about
this? My dad. That's KB's dad.
Oh, well. This is so weird. Like, this is more cringe than watching yourself in the actual show.
So, what's your favorite band?
I'm kind of old school. Do you know 340 Mom?
Love them. Need the reunion now.
Like, I don't know why. Like when this tape even started, I was like, that is the Kosi I know. The sweet Kosi playing for Kili. You know what I'm saying?
They're like the best breakup band ever.
Breakup band?
Yeah. Take Midnight for example. Like, why is he all alone on a Friday night?
Yeah, like, why does he keep calling her out like that? Like a stalker.
Damn, son.
Who else could have played for Kili about Kosi? Who? No one. Thank
so, what's your favorite band? I listened to it on repeat when KB and I broke up.
You and KB dated?
A while ago. But he's been my day one, so.
I didn't know about that. How come I don't know that part of the script?
I love him, but he just wouldn't work. He's not focused enough.
I don't know. I really think he pretends he's smart.
Wait. So Fikile thinks KB and her were not, I mean KB was not focused enough. Nah, this is not on, guys.
KB, no focus. My bro?
Girl, you're an actual. Loved it.
Mwah. Mwah. 10 out of 10 for Kosi. Baby girl, babes on the labels.
It's like such a strange feeling to think that this is the tape that got me the role. And watching it now, wow.
Okay, lastly, I'm watching Tabang Olaba's audition tape, my audition tape.
You want to sit here? No more than day your peeps.
Wow, I've changed so much from this.
You blink, there's a party in my house tonight. You wanna come?
Oh, he's speaking to blink.
Nah, that's not wrong.
Go Hursty! Who is this Hursty fam?
Jovicho.
I mean, man. What you mean, man? Let's go, Tabang.
Okay, now let's see. I'd love to hear what everyone else had to say because this was just... Mine was hard to watch, but I enjoyed everyone else's.
Hey guys, so you've all just been watching your audition tapes for Blood and Water. That was way back when, over a year ago. I see some cringing from a certain corner over here. But how did you, what was it like? Gail, you know, let's go with us oldies first. Let's have a chat.
Oldies, okay. It was weird, honestly, to sum it up in one word. It was very awkward. I don't generally watch myself on screen. To watch an audition was even worse. But I think, you know, you watch it and you're like, wow, it's more than a year ago. I've grown. Just the character has grown and developed. And it's also weird without the bells and the whistles, you know, because what the finished product looks very different to an audition. It was just weird. To sum it up, it was just like, I was watching like this, like, yo, okay, when? But it was a nice little throwback.
How did you feel watching it?
I cringed. Like, first of all, my lips are so dry. My lips were so dry. I don't know how, Nosifo, like, props to you. I don't know how you were able to look beyond how dry my lips were.
I probably thought you could put moisturizer on your lips. I probably thought you could just put some moisturizer.
But I don't know why you didn't stop me and say, girl, you need Vaseline or something, like, to put on your lips. Like, they were so dry. So for me, like, I was just really stuck on that. But it was very awkward, like, watching myself. I was like, oh my goodness, like, I could cringe right now. I was just like, wow, this is a lot. But I was, for most part, I won't lie, like, maybe it's just like my vanity or whatever, but I just could not stop looking at the fact that my lips are dry. Like, I don't know why I didn't have Vaseline or something just for my lips.
Great. And for you, the things actors think about. And for you, Dylan, I almost called you Wade now because I can't get Wade out of my head now. But for you, Dylan, what did you think? Have you ever watched yourself, your own audition tapes, by the way?
This is the first ever, so I didn't know, is this a normal thing that you like get to watch your audition tape? But I didn't know, like Bell said, I crit myself quite a bit. So it was weird for me to watch because I can't actually crit myself because that audition got me the role. So like I actually just looked at it and looked at the choices that I made. And I even think I pouted in the video. I was like, Dylan, what you doing? So for me, I literally laughed at myself while watching it. But it was a different type of experience, but a nice one at the same time.
Yeah. Let's go to.
Sorry, Christy, but I have a question. Sorry, who's Amy? Because I watched.
Who is Amy?
Like, who's Amy? So I watched Dylan's tape, and he was talking about an Amy. I'm like, who is Amy?
Amy.
Yeah, I was speaking to an Amy.
Who?
There's
who
the
is Amy?
To an Amy.
No, I remember. So what we have, because, you know, people like to spread scripts around. People like to share things and put things online. As a way of kind of confusing the enemy, we gave you guys, we would change the names for all the characters that weren't part of your audition itself. So that people, if those scripts did get out eventually, people wouldn't know exactly who was who. So I don't know who Amy was. It was a name that came to mind at the time.
Okay, cool. All right.
Kosi, how was watching your audition tape? You came in a few times for the audition as well. Different, I think you auditioned for like 80 different roles.
I know. Yeah. I was cringing, obviously, like everyone. I know I auditioned for Buleng and Fikile. And I just like the contrast between those two, like my interpretation of Buleng is so different to, in a way, to how Amma did. And I was like, yeah, for a good reason too. but I don't know, I was just cringing. And also seeing that audition and like the character, like my interpretation of the character in the actual series once we were shooting, it's just so weird to like based off, because for the audition I only had like the script and like that little blurb of information that we had, so like it's interesting to see how much growth I think, but yeah.
Tab on Mr. KB.
Yes, I feel the same way as Kosi feels. Final product KB is so different from the audition KB. So yeah, it's just different in so many ways. But I wasn't really, was I cringing? I'm not sure. I was just neutral, you know, I was indifferent. Yeah.
All right, guys. So the show is out now. And, you know, people have reactions to all the different characters, some people loving, some people hating certain ones. Now that you think about it, is there a character on the show, other than the character you've auditioned for, is there one that you're like, yo, I should have gone for that one? Let's switch it up. Let's start with Dylan.
I don't know. I honestly can't see myself playing anyone other than Wade. And I think it's mainly because of how well each and every castmate played the character. I can't see myself playing that role. I don't know. I honestly don't know. Maybe Sia. I don't know.
You think you would have made a good 12-year-old boy?
Part of our family shame, man.
It would have tested me to play younger than, yeah. I honestly don't know.
What is this? Listen, guys, film and TV is capable of many, many things, but I don't think we need to stretch it that far. You want to play a 12-year-old boy? Okay, how about you, Boo. Amma.
Yeah, I feel what Dylan said is like very true. I think everyone just really delivered in their role. I really can't see myself pulling off any other role but bullying, because I really feel like we all just, you know, it just, the cast narrator, good line, a shout out to him, man. He really just has an eye to see, okay, this person looks good as this person. Even like, not even performance, but even look, you know, everyone just suits like the look of their character. But a character I would have liked, you know, I just like her vibe, and I think it was really awesome was Wendy. I think, like, I just would have liked to be that, you know, in like, this is what it is.
I would have liked to hear Wendy say in click. just for that. Taba?
Listen, I have the same sentiment, you know. I feel like no one could have played anyone, you know, better than we already did. And yeah, KB, honestly, like, that's me. That's KB. Yeah.
It is.
Yeah, no, definitely.
It is indeed. I get you. What about you, Kosi?
I agree. I think also because I'm attached to Figile now, like, I can't see myself anywhere else. But if I were to pick someone else, maybe like Reese. That would be interesting. Yeah. Reese is cool, and like, she's got some nice edginess. That would be interesting. Right, but Figile, all the way.
Yeah. Reese is that character that's kind of like, I'm really just not interested in anything any of you have to do with, like, whatever drama you go through, that's your business. I'm just here to live my life and hustle. If you're boring, get out of my way.
Bye.
It would have been interesting to see you in an audition for that. And what about you, Gail?
Yeah, it's strange because I was trying to think while everyone was talking. I mean, I can't imagine being a mom to anyone else. I feel like the pairing between myself and Amma was, like everyone said, you know, everyone played their role so perfectly. But I like Reese. I also like, I keep forgetting Huling's best friend's name.
Zama.
Like Zama's character. I like the fact that she was very carefree, and you know, you tweeted the other day that Zama is that girl that we all wanted to be in high school, but we never had the guts to be her. And it's that whole vibe, you know, and that's what's cool with acting, is that you get to be these characters without taking responsibility in your normal life. So I think Zama's one of those characters. I also love Wade's character. If I could come back as a boy, I love the comedy. I love. And I can pull off, you know, I can really like pull off that sort of vibe.
There you are.
Get Okay, but what I would really like to know, Nasipo, is if you could be one character from the show, like, who would you be?
You know what? That's the easiest answer that I could possibly give you. I would 150%. What? I'd be?
You'd be Buleng.
No.
More
why
like
would
Wendy.
I want to be Buleng?
I thought there was a connection then, Nosipo. What?
No, why would I want to be Buleng? Like, she cries too much. She's got too many issues. No, I don't want that stuff. No.
Literally.
I would definitely want to be, I would audition for Wendy. I think Wendy is my alter ego. The guys kept saying to me at some point when we were writing, they were like, do you want to look over the scene and make sure this feels like Wendy? I was like, yeah, give it to me. Let's go. I'll change this dialogue. Yeah. I feel like that's a queen I stand, man.